And welcome back. My name is Heizgames. Welcome to more Splinter Cell. We're on part three. And last time we were here, we're kind of just making our way to the police precinct here. And we're trying to take down this agent. With no bullets left, so that could be an issue coming down the road here. Shoot out lights and things. Because they gave me 20 bullets, and I already used all of them, and then some that I had left. So I have 7 bullets left. I gotta make them last. I'm gonna try to do that. Wait, this looks like this must be the basement entrance. Interact, use keypad. So we already figured out the code was 5929. So that was previous. Oh god. Come the coppers. Being the light is not helpful. Get out of this light as soon as possible. The problem is this whole place is lit up. I ain't got any bullets for this.
I think I see something.
You can shoot me. Hi there. Kill me. Thank you. So I can sneak on the side door here, so I never even saw the door there. So we're gonna get in. Take this dude out.
Alright, show yourself.
What was that?
You're not supposed to be here.
Shit, some bullets right now.
Got the situation
here. This operation
here.
Is based around stealth. Watch the alarms.
There's no computer here, but I can't do anything. Alright, well, I ain't got bullets left, so. It's down to punching people. So let's get these dudes out of here, though, first. Because, it's gonna be a bad scene if there's dudes, you know, just chilling here. So I could take their bullets from like their guns that they have, but apparently that's not possible in this game. It would really be helpful. Let's hide bodies here. Let's see, first get need one of these badly.
Ooh.
Yeah, need one. There will be later. If desperate times call for desperate measures. We'll do that, but not right now. Stay down, we'd stay quiet. We're in a prison, a lot of lights, they ain't got bullets, so I gotta somehow stay quiet and not get spotted. Papers and computer here, I'll pack that. Guess that was supposed to help me, but it didn't. Wait a second, what was that? Was that? Oh shoot, just a soda. Extract the coppers. Guys, let's Let's just get out of here. That we had some information on it of some sort. Let's go to camera in the morgue. So I probably just got spotted. Excellent. Beautiful, because now I'm spotted in that morgue camera, because I was seen there wrong. It's a good place to hide bodies. If we need to do so. Over here in the staircase.
Who is that?
Hide him. Oh, wait a second. There's something on him. Get that in a moment. Take him downstairs. Put him in a nice little hiding spot. So he won't be spotted. I wonder if I just want to deal with it. I'm trying to go quick. Maybe not. I thought he had something on him, but apparently he didn't. Or if he did, I already got it. It's almost like an examination room, almost. Say. Let's see what the data stick has to say. Gentlemen, you'll be heading Crown Control during next Friday's political party at the square. His people have been warning me that the president plans to make some extremely inflammatory statements. He's getting the people riled up. You're ready for some big news in the next couple of weeks. And then it says, no tear gas, just keep the batons. So, basically, that guy's coming here, we see on the news at the beginning of the game. He's gonna say some stuff, probably anti-American, because, you know, why not? That's why we're here. And then basically, this is stuff.
Somebody there? Oh, Jesus!
He got scared. Alright, don't worry about me, buddy. Not here to take your stuff. I'm actually looking for bullets, trying to scavenge what's left. Well, looks like there's nothing out here, dang it. Came into the basement. This is like a 2 or 3 story building. Speaking of, I got a couple stories to fill up. Who knows how many cops are at the facility. Let's get our position here crouched.
What was that noise? Something's moving.
I'm dead. Great. Alright, so we have this guy taken out. Just kind of snuck up behind him in his chair. Gave him a nice little whack. take him to the back corner over here. I think I'm going to take him outside. Bushes or something. There you go. Well, that's not great, but it'll do good enough. It'll do the job. Close enough. Alright, time to go back upstairs. Get this job off. One last guy now. Gosh, he's got no sudden movements. Get him in his chair and take him out. Sneaking closer. Just a little bit more. Get out of here. There's a closet. Plant in the corner might work too. Closet would be better. Oh, there's a lot of doors in this room. Look for it. Door's locked. I'm gonna use this one. This one's gonna have the clicking. Oh wait, I need to lock pick it. So lock pick out first. Click and lock. Lock it. Picking the buttons. Correct here. That was easy enough. Interrogation room of some sort. The body, here's the body. Put it in here. Someone's gonna have a crude surprise and they wake up in the morning and find a. Turn on the light to find that. Hopefully, by the time that happens, I'll be out of the epilepsy. This is locked as well. Alright, give me the lock pick and mash buttons. Wait a second, I had it. See that? Had it. Just for a second. But just gotta. Can I get the right. There we go. The right one. Eventually, when you can get the door to open right, a crack. And I think part of the reason they did that is because obviously, I'm kind of playing this game 1080p, which is not supposed to be played at. Well, it's supposed to be playing at 60 frames, and for some reason the game doesn't like recording a period because anytime I record, my frame rate jumps from about 100 to about 20s. But you can't really tell because this game
runs. Who is that?
Whiz. Okay, hello. Get a stick. So here you are, Satchel, but the one problem with you is you're in my way. So I had to knock you out before you tried to kill me. Or attempted to. So it would have been funny if he was like gonna help me. Is it like getting me information? And I just like knocked him out for no reason. Probably the kids. He didn't look like he was actually gonna shoot me. Surprise. Most of the guys just like pull out their guns and run away and start rapidly firing their guns. And for some reason people in this work are not smart enough to when they one of their coworkers shoots to start following suit. So usually in most cases that's the right thing to do. In most cases, not every case. But most cases. Let's see, in this room's camera. This must oh, it's like mass computers here. Hack into these. Gonna give us some information, maybe a data stick or something. So basically, no one trusts this Kevendly dude. But no one in his work trusts him or really likes him. It's not a good sign, you know, if you're a boss and you're not getting trusted or liked. The only thing I'm a little concerned about that guy is the only guy who actually had a name. That's why I feel like he may actually be able, I don't know what you want to call it, to help us. But if he would, if that was the case, then it would have, he would have been knocked out, right? He would, it would have, mission would have failed as soon as I KO'd him. But I don't know, man. Find a way, continue pushing forward. I'm gonna turn these lights on. I just tackle these computers. I feel like this agent dude's not here tonight. Sorry. That's why the phone's ringing right now. Door. See, it pops up just, I think it's the door operation. This would be the big one, right? That looks like it'd be the big one, but apparently not. I'm trying to locate this Agent Blackstone. We found much information except for some data sticks. It's basically are more just like lives of the people here and USB flash drives, but it's not the actual. What am I supposed to do? Now is the question. There's five rooms up here if you can't tell. This, one of these rooms has a secret passage that I do not know about. Wait, there's ammo. I saw that. Yes. Thank the heavens I got some ammo. Let me get my gun out here. Let's reload real quick. Things do go south, so I'm gonna have to take them out. Just like Agent Blostein, but we haven't seen him. If any one of these people, none of them have been him yet. So the question is, where is Agent Blostein? Is this him right here? Why is there this guy in the interrogation room just knocked out cold? This is the security camera room. I feel like this is gonna be the room of answers. So we're using. Let's see if there's, if they give us any more hints. Notes. You're supposed to locate Agent, what's his name, but I don't see him anywhere. Did I check this room out? I think I did, didn't I? I feel like I already checked this room out, too. This is a garbage camera. I don't want that. Okay, where do I go now? Must be something. Maybe like a hidden bookshelf or something? It seemed like the complete picture. Desk. Just don't know exactly what to do right now. Alright, everybody, so this thing's kind of confusing. So, forgot to shoot that security camera, which was actually really important. Because basically that leads me to track my way up here in this room with security cameras. So, that's why the mission never continued. Now we can finally go up and finish this mission off. Now I should really hear correctly this time.
Great work, Fisher. We're scanning the videotapes now.
There.
That's our guy. We got him red-handed.
Can you run his face through Echelon?
Already on it. Hey, check it out. A license plate. 84KP214.
Fantastic. Fisher, we got what we need. Rendezvous with Wilkes, your work here is done. We'll get back to you once we've sifted this intel.
Question for extraction at the outside. Yeah, in front of the police precinct. Let's get here for the cops to figure out that we've shot half the department up. Or docked them out cold. Here we go. Hey. First mission complete. Now I can see what's going on next. Well, Sam Fisher.
Mark a steady rise in Georgia's economy. Once central to the former Soviet Union's development and manufacture of weapons, Georgia has recently resurfaced as a potential player in the world military industry, with active contracts in Russia, Turkey, Germany, and even has stated the need, especially in these times, for a reliable source of oil in the Middle East. Commerce Secretary Moore, on a visit to Azerbaijan this morning, noted the tiny nation's enormous potential for oil, calling on American investors to provide the necessary funds for tapping the reserves.
In many ways, a leader from a bygone era. His beliefs are very firmly founded in Georgian orthodoxy. His political standing's more in line with the early 20th century.
Would you fault him, then, as a politician?
No, not at all. Kumbay Nikolats is all politician. He's done wonders for the Georgian economy. A brilliant tactician. It's more a question of ethics.
And ethically speaking?
Well...
Alrighty. Discover President's secret. See, agents Blackstein and Madison were killed for getting too close to information Georgian President Kumbay Nikolats needed to protect. A Russian missionary is closely tied to his secret. They have need to meet at the Ministry of Defense.
Echelon got a positive ID on your target from the morgue security cameras. A guy named Vyacheslav Vinko.
How do I find him?
By his license plate.
And if he's not with his car?
Then his driver will be. Grab him and make him talk. Don't be afraid to use force.
Who? Me?
Grimm's daughter just pulled up the schematics on the ministry. They've got a laser security grid online in the courtyard.
So I stay out of the courtyard.
Don't let them trigger any alarms at all. We still don't have any official approval from the Joint Chiefs for this operation. So one slip up and it's mission over.
It's apparently doing this mission without approval. That's a great way to do things. Down. We can't go in the courtyard from what I've been seeing. As far as it goes down, seriously? So we gotta jump to here. Get off of this thing. Just click. No. Cigar. Migo. How do I get off this? Button mashing. Get off. How do I get off the freaking thing? Button mashing right now. It's not working. Let me out, please. Right, actually, here it is. So actually, if you don't know this window, it looks like right here. It's my way in. I like things. So gotta find and interrogate this driver.
What the hell? Oh. Ah!
That ain't gonna help me. Or is it like a mine?
That's one alarm too many. Mission's over.
Great. Oh, so there's a security camera. Camera right there. Baby out. So that's where the beeping is. So if you see beeping, then you automatically know it's a security camera. Super hack in here. Another data stick. Coffee. Here. Or better stick in the shadows. Hope this guy isn't so active. I can take him down. I'm trying to interrogate this driver dude. Whatever his purpose is. If he just comes down here and keeps going. Dang, he's going back. I would have gone for him otherwise. Hide behind you. Got some light, be easier to see what we're looking at. We got two guys here. This one's kind of just patrolling. Another guy who's just chilling. We've got the patrolling guy and we've got the chilling guy. This guy. Come up. Staircase. Flag. Camera in that room, too. Baby real quick. Okay, this one as well. This door's locked. I'll get my lockpick out before I actually start mashing buttons here. Disposable pick, lockpick, optic cable, laser mic. I'm not quite sure I'm gonna need a laser mic, but we really have to mash this to even get it, the lockpicking game to even work. Okay. Some magic tricks here.
I need a colonel down here. We're trying to get through a retinal scanner.
I pressed Colonel Kibiashvili on my patrol. Want me to send him down?
God, no. I hate this guy. We'll find somebody else with the lamp.
some soldiers complaining about, you know, their work. I feel like we're not supposed to go out. It's a health kit. There's always a reason for everything. The med kit this time. So we got a little bit of way to recoup our health here, just in case, you know, things go south. Like, really south, like I'm almost dead south. Just the forge came from correct. Yeah, the bodies are right there, I can see them. My night vision goggles. I can't access because the bar's over it. We're down. Yep, you're not getting a glimpse of me, motherfuckers. I don't think so. Not my watch. Put you guys down. Is that one around here? Not this floor. Next floor, like I said, and the previous two. No, apparently not. Alright. So we're in the parking garage now, essentially. Find this driver, dude. God, there's another camera. I wonder what these people think when all your cameras just start going down. Apparently, not much, because not sending a lot of help, but again, this is a parking garage, for crying out loud. It's not much supposed to be going on here. It's like an elevator shaft that's not in operation. Okay, so there's the car right there. License plate don't match what she said. Security camera. I heard it before I saw it, but I heard it. This one over here.
Have been nothing.
That's his car. how he even saw me, but alright.
Hey! Holy mess! What the hell?
I'm going to ask you some questions. When I think you're lying, I'll do this.
I...
Who do you work for?
Vyacheslav Grinko.
Tell me about him.
He used to be Spetsnaz. Now he's mercenary. He works for President Nicholas.
Where do I find Grinko?
He's meeting Mass in the elevator by the courtyard.
Who's Mass?
Philippe Mass, some computer guy. He has access.
What's this meeting about?
I don't know. I swear, it's gotta be something bad if Nicholas is willing to see Grinko face to face.
I need you to understand that we never talked.
I understand.
Good. Convince me we never talked.
If anybody finds out, Grinko will murder me.
And you're frightened of Grinko?
God, yes! I swear, I've already forgotten you!
I want to hear what Grinko and Mass talk about in that elevator.
I'll need to deactivate the courtyard laser grid to get in position.
Then do it!
South wing. Alrighty, so I gotta go to deactivate the elevator. But anyway guys, I'm gonna stop here, everybody. So thanks for watching. Now please rate, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next part of, Splinter Cell. Have a great day, everybody.